The Lord has made. Please take out one of the Bibles, page 899. In the 10th chapter of the Gospel of Christ that was proclaimed by the great evangelist St. Luke, I gave that emphasis because quite often people will say the Gospel of St. Luke, the Gospel of St. Mark, these are not their Gospels. There's only one Gospel, it's the Gospel of Jesus Christ. These people wrote down what they saw and heard, but it is not their Gospel, it's Christ's Gospel. One of the people that come here, they were talking about the Bible, they said, well, you know, in Matthew, I said, who? They said, Matthew. I said, who's Matthew? He said, Saint Matthew. Even the King James Version refers to the apostles as St. Luke, St. Mark, St. John, St. Matthew. So let's have a little bit. But I gotta tell you honestly, yesterday I was at Disney World, thanks to Kinsey Simmons, who got some tickets. And I have a habit, I don't go to Disney World that often, but when I go there, I give you a little hint. If you don't want to park your car in the parking lot with 18 million other cars, and you spend 2 hours trying to find a car, unless you have a dead bear on top of it, I would suggest you do what I do when I park at the hotel. The Polynesians, the Grand Floridian, whatever. I parked at the hotel. So yesterday, I was going to the hotel. It's a very expensive hotel, the Polynesian. The people were dressed like they were going to a little league game. And I thought, my God, there's no say in Arabic. They say, Bala Asli. They have no background. Of course, I remember very well in this country when people used to dress properly. It's not something that was forced on us, but something that we grew up with. So I went through the hotel and I saw these people, and now I forget the cutoffs and the hats on it. Does anybody remember that it is proper for men inside to turn their hats off? You know, my mother, God rest her, my mother had breakfast every weekday at a restaurant in Maitland, and she'd walk in, if somebody had his hat on, she'd say, take your hat off. And so I'm like, lucky that I didn't get hit by somebody all the time. So if we don't do things properly, now we wind up with chaos. Is what we see with our children today in America, chaos. Because they don't know anything proper, they're not even taught anything proper, because we don't want to maybe want to upset them. Before I began, Mrs. Solak was reading, the Boston prayers. I heard some running upstairs. The Sunday school was meeting upstairs over the hall. I ran up there and said, who's running? And they said, the kids are there. I said, stop running. It's a church. Don't run in here. You know why they stopped running? Because they were shocked. Not because they were afraid, because they were shocked, because no told them. So it says here in this 25th verse, at that time a lawyer stood up to put him to the test, saying, teacher, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? He that against the man who is in the Musi or Kama Yujahidu, Kaiden Yamu Alimu, Mata Amaru, the Arisa, Arisa, Hayyut al Abadiyata. May the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Eternal life is salvation. And we know from the scripture that salvation is a gift from God. You cannot acquire it on your own. But you can do something to go towards it. St. Paul says, show me your faith, I'll show you my actions. I have little, in fact, I have no appreciation or respect for people that talk the talk and don't walk the walk. Every priest, pastor, rabbi, everyone in religion is always being told the same thing. We need to get somebody. I've said this before, if I ever meet someone and I tell them, what is your name, and they say, somebody, I'm going to tell them, boy, do I have a lot of stuff that I've been looking for you to do for the last 40 years. There's no person called somebody. So we have to do something with our faith. It's not enough to go and say, oh, I believe. I had a fellow one time who was, nominally Orthodox. And he was talking with a Muslim, and you're the Muslims, they don't believe in the Trinity. They misunderstand his talking. So he said to the Muslim, well, we really just believe in Jesus. He left out the Father and the Spirit. So afterwards, I'm good for this. One of the things that the Lord gave me a talent for is putting people on the spot. So I went to him and I said to him, you're a liar. He said, what? I said, you're a liar. He said, what are you talking about? I said, the last time I went to church, I heard you say, I believe in one God, the Father, Almighty, Maker, Heaven, so on and so forth, and the Holy Spirit. You're a liar. You don't believe in the Father. You don't believe in the Holy Spirit. You believe just in Jesus Christ. So we have to do something when we say we believe. Do we believe? You know, there's disciples in different churches over the years, maybe for a service or someone or whatever it was. And some of the churches, I don't know which ones, they say, we believe. This is wrong. It's wrong. You can't say what other people believe. It's what I believe. And I say, I believe. Not the way we believe, what they believe, or that's what they should. I believe. So when you say, I believe, God's listening. He's saying, do you really? So if we believe that we have salvation, what are we doing with it? If we're doing nothing, and I will tell you honestly, there are lots and lots of people. I'm going to tell you something. If I don't go to heaven, I can understand it. But I am definitely not going to go to hell because I missed church on Sunday. There is no way that I'm going to hell. If I drop dead tomorrow, the Lord might say, you're going to heaven, go to hell. But not because I missed church on Sunday. I never missed church on Sunday. You might say, well, you're getting paid. Really? You really think that? I gotta tell you something, I'm here in church today because I get something out of this. So our salvation is something that we have to participate in. It's not enough just to say, I believe. So when he says, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? Okay, and Jesus says to him, what did you read? He said, you know, I love the Lord, I love the Lord, my heart, Lord, is all over mine, and my neighbor and myself. Jesus said, you said well. And the man in his letter that wouldn't be fine. Because he said, after he said, and what do I do to be perfect? Read the words very carefully. What do I do to inherit eternal life? Believe in God and love your neighbor, love the Lord. That'll get you eternal life, he says. But he says, what would I be perfect? To be perfect. And he tells the story about this man. And I think, you know, Rehab, except those with that Arabic, Rehab is the name of Jericho. Like it yet? You know what the word Rehab means in Arabic? Stinky smell. Sorry? It's different than smell?
Rehab is a smell, but Rehab is a city and Jerusalem.
Okay, different words. Same word, different meaning. Same word, different meaning.
No.
Rehab is
a city and Jerusalem. And
Rehab
is a smell.
I've been to Rehab. And it smells. Anyhow, the point is that he says to him, the man was going to Areha, okay? And he got off. So he says here, so likewise a Levite, when he came to the place and saw a pass by the other side. Wakadalika Liwiyun, Aiden Isara, and El Makani, Ja'a Wanazara, Wajaza, Mukabila. He passed by the other side. He saw the guy. He saw him. And he went on the other side. He didn't want to deal with him. Does that happen to anybody in this room? You see a homeless person, you see a person that maybe they're drunk, whatever it is, they might need help. You pass by the other side. You don't want to help. None of you, maybe one or two, you didn't know my dad. My dad, God rest his soul, worked in a nightclub in New York. That was his business. He was an entertainer. And when he died in 1977, we had the funeral here at St. George, and then we took his remains up to Brooklyn because that's where the cemetery was. And we had a little viewing for him at the funeral parlor up there in Brooklyn. And a man came in. I didn't know who the man was. He said, are you his son? I said, yes. He said, I want to tell you about your father. I said, go ahead. He said, one night I was at the nightclub and I drank way more than I should have. and I was trying to get a taxi to go home, and your father went and got me a private car. In those days, $50 was a lot of money. So he got me a private car and sent me home. Came back a couple of days later, a couple of years later, and I asked him, why did you do that? And of course, I gave your dad the money back, but I asked him, why did you do that? He said, because I knew that it was a possibility somebody might wrong me. My father just rightly got it off. I was very proud of my father for doing that. So when we see people that are in need, that people, maybe they don't want to touch them, they don't want to be involved with them, they might smell, they may have riha, okay? But we ignore them. And that's what this Levite did. He saw this man beaten almost for the inch of his life, practically dead. And he still went and did something for him. So can you just say, but you know, I'm sorry, he didn't leave a couple of denarii on his bloody clothing and hope somebody else was there. He picked him up, he poured out oil and wine to try and anticipate or antiseptic of his wounds, put him on his animal, took him to an inn, took care of him, and told the guy, listen, I've got to leave him when I, if you have to spend anything else, I'll give it to when I come back. He did something. He did something. We had an election last week. And I'm not going to get into the election, but I will tell you that one of the things I feared after the results of the election were known was that the people that would get hurt the most, possibly, with a different administration, were the poor, the people that we try to help. And on Wednesday night, I told our Bible study, I said, you know, we have a blessed opportunity as Christians to do something for these people that might not be being done any longer by the government. Okay, we can really show these people that we really care about, that we really see them, that they're important to us. This is an opportunity that we might have. So when we talk about walking the walk, we talk about really doing something, not just sitting there saying, oh, and we're, I know this word when I was a kid growing up, haram, 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 which means like sad thing, poor thing, shouldn't happen. Do something about the haram. Don't just look at the haram and do nothing and say, haram. Do something. And that's what this man did. And finally it says here in verse 37, he said, the one who showed mercy, he said, the one who showed mercy to him, that was his neighbor. And Jesus said to him, go and do likewise. فَقَالَ أَلَّذِي سَنَعَ مَعَهُ الرَّحْمَةَ فَقَالَ لَهُ يَسُوْ إِسْحَبْ أَنْتَ أَيْدٍ وَأُسْنَعَ حَكَّزَ. When I talk about mercy, and you know the most oft-repeated phrase in the Orthodox liturgy is Lord have mercy. Yad avortam, ispika, ospodi pomalamsia, kiria deso, Lord have mercy. We say the word mercy, and so important is this word that we don't really think about it. You know that when they say in French, merci, it comes from the word mercy. Because years ago, people, when someone did something for them, they had nothing to pay to give them something like a gift. So they would say, merci. May the mercy of God come on you. Even in Spanish, what do they say? Gracias. What does gracias mean? It means grace. May the grace of God come on you for what you did to me. So we talk about mercy. We're talking about not only the mercy of God, we're talking about our mercy. You want to be merciful? You got to. Go to the Walmart or whatever store you go to. Go to the bank, wherever you bank. And there will be somebody there in the line that will ignore you. Too slow. Don't have the money out. Trying to play with a debit card that says only credit cards. 40 items instead of 25. Taking forever at the bank. I was at Walmart the other day and some man came up to me, African American, and I said, bro, you don't want to stand on this line. He said, there's only three people ahead of you. I said, bro, believe me, you don't want to stand. Any line I'm in, going to be the long line. I don't care what line it is, the minute I get in that line, they discover that they don't have whatever it is that they need. So we need to be merciful in those situations. When you're driving on the road, guys are going a little too slow. Give them a break. Okay, be a little merciful. It's not just the mercy of someone getting, they're going to get their head cut off. We need to be more merciful. Be merciful to the animals. I believe this. I'm sorry, you may not like what I said, but to me, people that don't have an affection or a likeness or we say in Arabic, hanun, a compassion for animals, there's something wrong with them. Now, I understand some people are afraid about it. I understand that. Maybe they got bit when they were a child or their cultural thing. I understand all that. But the point is, give the animal a break. I think, because I ride a bike. You ever see somebody riding a bike walking a dog? Have you seen that? Have you seen that, Sonia? I mean, the poor dog can hardly keep up, and this guy's riding a bike. I saw someone the other day and said, hey, you know what? Why don't you stop before the poor dog is trying to do his business, and he's dragging the dog as he's riding the bike. Have some mercy on the animal. Feed the animal. Pet the animal. Have some mercy on the environment. Okay? Have some mercy on stop throwing so many things out. We talk about mercy, but I'm just talking about mercy of people. Have mercy on the fact that God gave us all these things and we should be merciful and not take them for granted. I've said this so many times. We take what we have for granted. We don't appreciate it. And that, my friends, leads us to not appreciating the animals, the material, the money, the gifts of God, and not appreciating the greatest gift of God, which is the people. You say, why is the greatest gift of God? What did Jesus say? He said, love God and love your neighbor. Who's your neighbor? It's the guy at Walmart that can't find his debit card. It's the guy going slow on I-4. That's your neighbor. The people that are annoying you are your neighbors. So be merciful to these people. Show them some love. It's the people that you might hate them. You hate what they represent. I remember very clearly. A person came to me years and years and years ago and said, I'm angry at you. I said, okay, what do I do now? They said, I heard that you like the Jews. They were Middle Eastern people. I said, I do. I don't agree with a lot of what they do. And what they do that I don't like, I say I don't like it. But I'm not going to stop liking them because it may bother you. So we have to remember that our mercy, especially to the people that we don't like, the people that upset us, the people that annoy us, the people that do wrong to us, that's where the mercy is. It's easy to be merciful to those that are nice to you. It's easy. But when you're there, when you're merciful, when you're kind, when you're understanding, when you're loving to those who are not, it says in the Bible, then you've done something. Even the sinner gives to those from whom he expects to receive back. But the Christian gives to those who he knows he's not getting it back. And he seeks only the blessing of God. Father, Son, and Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Christmas is not a family holiday.
Christmas is a religious holiday, holy day. So in order for us to maybe refocus the priority of Christmas, we are blessed to have the Advent fast. Not just a matter of not eating meat, it's a matter of refocusing ourselves to the true meaning and the blessing of the birth of Jesus Christ into our lives. So we have a luncheon we prepared downstairs which has meat, and I hope that you will stay for that. The luncheon is free. Some people find that to give donations, and we do really appreciate that. We'll have a discussion table during the luncheon. Our topic is what actually, people don't understand this, what actually is eternal life? Big was insane about what eternal life is. I hope you'll stay for that. Also, I'd like to wish all those who are named after St. John Chrysostom happy name day. Of course, today is the holy day of St. John Chrysostom. Again, our love to Liz, Alexander, and Alessandro, the Lord we had today. We've spoken a lot about the air conditioner. I was supposed to have a meeting next week. I'll be having a meeting. I did have a meeting last week. I'm sorry. Could be talking anywhere from $100,000 to now $300,000. Tremendous amount of money. This building is a historical landmark. Just don't come in here and drop a couple of 5,000 BTU units into it. I will have another meeting this coming Wednesday. So if you have not as yet given towards the new air conditioner, we need you to do so as soon as possible because this is going to be very, very big. It would make us as much as cost us to buy the church in the first place. Also, I remind you that we're coming to that time of the year of Nativity where we ask people to sponsor these lights up here. They're $25 each. I ask each one to at least take a minimum of two, one for your living and those who are departed like before us. Also, remind you that there is great, we have bread downstairs. I want to thank you, Marina, here. Thank you, Marina, who was very kind to wrap the bread so professionally in the plastic wrapping. That bread is free, but again, a donation is appreciated. Efforts to try and raise some funds for the church. Also, we have a possible trip coming up either December the 3rd or 10th to St. Augustine. Just a fellowship trip to go. We'll be carpooling as we get a tremendous amount of view that we'll rent the bus, but right now we're carpooling. I'm going to go up probably around noon because the city is very beautifully decorated for Christmas. So I think that would be a great thing for us to go up there. We'll be able to see that there's a beautiful Orthodox shrine up there. This is something that you might be interested in. Just let me know. You don't have to sign it in blood. Just let me know that you might be interested so we can get an idea of many people would like to do this. I remind you again that our fellowship hall is closed. It's all been dismissed with divine liturgy. And finally, I remind you that if you have not as yet given your membership offer to the church, that you please do so as soon as possible. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, we do love you especially. Thank you for the blessed day. Blessed place in which you worship you and ask God for all of us. Help us with that will. Help us to come on Wednesday, Lord, for Bible study. On Friday morning, the liturgy of Mainland. And on Friday evening, for the social Bible study that we offer. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. The two-line distribution has blessed all the bread to be.